السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين ولا إله إلا الله إلهنا وإله الأولين والآخرين وقيوم السماوات والأرضين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه أرسله الله تبارك وتعالى رحمة للعالمين إماما للمتقين وحجة علينا نحن الخلائق أجمعين فأخرجنا به من ظلمات الكفر إلى نور الإيمان بالله رب العالمين فاللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد إخوة الإسلام فما زلنا نتحدث سويا عن هذه الأمراض التي تصيب قلوبنا وتحول بيننا وبين أن نبلغ مرتبة القلب السليم. So my dear brothers and listening sisters, we're still with the main topic that we have for a few weeks now, talking about the diseases of the heart that stand between you and achieving the sound heart that should be your goal from this life, to meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a sound heart As he said, subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Shu'ara, إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ الأسبوع الماضي تحدثنا عن هذا المرض الخبيث الذي يصيب قلوب معظم العباد، لا نقول كل العباد، وإنما معظمنا مصاب بهذا المرض، هذه الغفلة التي نهانا عنها الله سبحانه وتعالى وذم الكافرين بها. قال سبحانه وتعالى: يعلمون ظاهرا من الحياة الدنيا وهم عن الآخرة هم معرضون. هذه الغفلة التي جعلها الله تبارك وتعالى عقابا لبعض عباده، قال سبحانه وتعالى: أولئك الذين طبع الله على قلوبهم وسمعهم وأبصارهم وأولئك هم الغافلون. هذه الغفلة التي تورث وتورث هذا التكاسل وهذه الإلفة أو الألفة مع المعصية وهذه الحالة من استصغار الذنوب، حتى أصبحنا لا نفرق بين صغير ولا كبير من الذنوب، بل نذنب ولا نبالي. هذه الغفلة التي لها أسباب كثيرة تحدثنا عن بعضها الأسبوع الماضي، ونستكمل اليوم إن شاء الله تعالى مع العلاج. So we started last week talking about heedlessness, الغفلة. You will see me or you will hear me using the word الغفلة most of the time, which means heedlessness. This heedlessness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the kuffar with, when he said subhanahu wa ta'ala fi surah ar-Rum, they know what's apparent of this worldly life, but when it comes to the akhirah, they know nothing. This heedlessness that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it as a punishment for some people, it's not only that you are afflicted by it, it's actually a punishment. When you are heedless, it's a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who are the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, over their hearts, their vision, their hearing, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sealed. And those are the heedlessness, or the heedless. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْغَافِلُونَ. Many things that comes with ghafla, you will find yourself, and I'm telling you, and I told them, just trying to summarize what we had last week. If you have one of these things, you have to be very careful. If you're lazy when it comes to the ibadah, when it comes to the salah, meaning that you are afflicted by ghafla. There is ghafla in your heart. When you're looking at the dhunub, at the sins, that it's always minor and it's always okay, and you do it in public and you don't pay attention to that, make sure that you are afflicted by ghafla, and you have to work harder to get yourself out of this, to awaken that fitra that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you with, al-fitra al-salima, to reach the sound heart. Many reasons we counted, or I listed two of them for the ghafla last week. تحدثتُ عن سببين. And I have وعندي بعض الأسباب الأخرى ثم العلاج إن شاء الله تعالى. So we talk about few of the reasons of the ghafla. I covered only two of them, and then I promise that إن شاء الله today we'll try to give some solution. If we're afflicted, all of us afflicted by ghafla, what should I do? What can I do to get myself out of this status and not to leave myself always in ghafla? حينما تحدثنا عن الأسباب قلت أولا المعصية، وذكرنا حديث ورواية سيدنا عبد الله بن مسعود أن المؤمن يرى ذنوبه كأنه جالس تحت جبل يخاف أن يقع عليه. Number one, we said that committing sins gets you always in this status of غفلة. You have to stop no matter what is it. والأمر الثاني تحدثت عن حب الدنيا ولم أفرط فيها كثيرا، ولكن بينت أننا كلنا ماهر في مجاله، وحينما تأتي للدين تجد الإنسان يعني أبعد ما يكون. Said when we said about the life, about the worldly life, everybody loves life. And everybody is so clever and smart when it comes to his field, when it comes to the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when it comes to his practicing his religion, is far. Before I go to the third reason for ghafla, I just read a hadith today that I want to share with you. And maybe I need somebody after the khutbah to remind me with this hadith, inshallah ta'ala. Hadith, قرأته اليوم, يعطيك هذا المعنى. أننا ماهرون جدا بأمور الحياة وحينما نأتي للآخرة لا شيء. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم حديث رواه ابن حبان في صحيحه وأورده البيهقي في سننه عن سيدنا أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله يبغض كل جعذري جواف سخاب بالأسواق. I need somebody to say this hadith at the end of the khutbah, inshallah ta'ala. إن الله يبغض كل جعذري جواف سخاب بالأسواق جيفة بالليل وحمار بالنهار عالم بأمور الدنيا جاهل بأمور الآخرة. حديث summarize everything. Summarize, يعني if you, I'm not saying that it describes somebody in particular, but many people like that. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not like every جعذري. والجعذري هو هذا المتكبر الذي لا يرى غيره. So the word جعذري means somebody who's always arrogant. He looks down to everybody. He walks, he doesn't care. جواظ هو الجموع المنوع. Somebody who looks and collects, gather, earns money for the purpose of money. جموع منوع. Collects money just to look at his bank account. How beautiful is it? When the money gets more and more and more, to pay back, no way. He loves money, just for money. سخاب بالأسواق, at work, outside, in the street, always fighting, screaming, shouting. جيفة بالليل, night time he is like a dead body. He goes to bed, one, two, whatever it is, sleeps as a dead body. Fajr, he doesn't know about Fajr, man. Let's not talk even about Salatul Layl. He goes, no matter what time he goes to bed, he goes early, he goes late, he sleeps like dead body. جِيفَةٍ بِاللَّيْلِ وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ وَحِمَارٍ بِالنَّهَارِ. His day like a donkey. Goes for food, for drink, for pleasure. He doesn't care about anything. No prayer, no ibadah, no nothing. عَالِمٌ بِأُمُورِ الدُّنْيَا. Everything about this life he's aware of. وَجَاهِلٌ بِأُمُورِ الدِّينِ. أو بأمور الآخرة. When it comes to آخرة, don't think that these descriptions come to somebody who will think about the آخرة. When it comes to آخرة, he is zero. He doesn't know anything. That's why Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that this person will as well always in ghafla because of this attachment to the dunya. Number four or number three of the reasons that gets you always attached to أول عز وجل gets you in the status of غفلة. الأمر الثالث كما يقول علماء هو طول الأمل. يا أخي بعض الناس تراه مهما كبر سنه متعلق بالدنيا, تحدثه في الدين لا يبالي, تحدثه عن الآخرة لا يبالي. كبر أم صغر لا يبالي. لذلك رب العالمين سبحانه وتعالى يقول في بدايات سورة الحجر ذوهم يأكلوا ويتمتعوا ويلهيهم الأمل. يا أخي, we are actually being deceived by hope. Number three is the hope. You, يعني حتى بعض العلماء قال عجبت لمن علم أو لمن طال أمله والموت ينتظر. I'm just amazed about somebody who's always looking for eternal life while he knows for sure that he's gonna die. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Hijr, let them eat and enjoy themselves and be diverted by the hope, by the amal that we have. You know, and don't deny it. One of the reasons of our ghafla, that we're not closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is that you and I always planned for eternal life. Whatever you do today, you never thought, or you never think that you're dying soon. Nobody's planning for leaving this dunya in a short time. Forever. I'm here forever. ولذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث رواه الإمام مسلم في صحيحه عن سيدنا أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه يقول مرة كنت بكلم راجل كبير أقول له يا أخي يعني أبنائك راجل كبير عنده 90 سنة أبنائك يعني أصغر منك شوي أبنائك يبيعون الخمور فقال لي يا أخي يا شيخ دعهم يبيعون وفي آخر حياتهم يروحوا يعملوا حج ينظفوا العملية وخلاص يعني look how some people think somebody I was talking to him يا أخي حرام your children they're selling liquors يعني حرام it's one of the grave sins يعني you need to talk to them said يا شيخ just let them sell now when they grow older they will go make hajj then they will come fine يعني no problem they will clean everything some people they live like that I'm telling you when you tell somebody now يا أخي يعني ربا interest is حرام قلت لي يا أخي listen يا شيخ إن شاء الله تعالى in the future I'm planning والله I'm planning 20 years from now إن شاء الله تعالى I'm gonna pay everything off I'm gonna be able to get out of this I'm gonna sell my car that I have for loan and I'm gonna get rid of the house you're not gonna do anything because you will have more hope at that time ليه يا شيخ why are you saying that you know what when you grow older I think we will look bitter to this life no you're not Yeah, we don't have wisdom more than the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول في الحديث عن سيدنا أنس بن مالك يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم يهرم ابن آدم يهرم يبلغ من العمر أرذلة يزيد عمرا وتشب معه اثنتان كل ما يكبر في حاجتين بيكبروا معاه حب الدنيا وطول الأمل حب المال وطول الأمل حب المال وطول الأمل The Prophet ﷺ said in the authentic hadith, as reported by Sayyidina Anas ibn Malik, recorded by Imam Muslim, that the son of Adam, the child of Adam, grows older and as two things or two desires grows older with him. The more you grow older, two desires grow older with you. Number one is love for this wealth and money. Hubbul mal. Love for money, for wealth. Don't think that when you grow older, you will be less in love with your wealth today. You will be more. So you have to stop this. You have to get out of this ghafla. And number two, hope for long life. Yeah, I'm telling you. That's why you will find some people, and I had this. I had this in person with somebody who was so old. And then he had to think about going to a fortune teller or whatever, magician, whatever it is, to tell him if he's gonna die soon or not. Wallahi, someone I know personally, he was asking me about istikhara. Why you have to do istikhara? Very old in age, why? He said, you know what? I wanna know why. And it turned out, he told me later on that, I wanna يعني, see if I'm dying soon or not. Yeah, I'm telling you, the more you grow older, the more attachment you have with this life. And that's the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Many reasons for this. Sadiq al-su, this bad friend that gets you wal-iyadu billah away and gets you in ghafla, tells you let's go out. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala yaqul wa yawma fi surat al-furqan wa yawma ya'addu al-zalimu ala yadayhi yaqulu ya laytani ittakhadhtu ma'a al-rasuli sabila ya waylata ليتني لم أتخذ فلانا خليلا لقد أضلني عن الذكر. Yeah, one of the reasons of the ghafla, this friend that takes you away from the right path, that tells you, you know what, let's go have nice time outside and not to go to the masjid. That tells you, أخي خلاص, you pay too much, don't pay more. يا أخي, why you have to go for hajj? Just you need this money. You can start a business with it. That tells you, you know what? When you have a problem with your wife, not to fix it with your wife, just divorce her. Allah, I have this. This is a very bad trend in Edmonton. Get somebody with his friend. His friend is in a problem with his wife. Tabo, none of your business. Sometimes I say it clearly. It's none of your business. But the problem is the husband is bringing him with him. He's coming with him. And he's talking on his behalf. Sheikh, I think she deserves divorce. Who are you? Why are you talking about it? Be careful, ya akhi. On the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَ يَعَبْدُ الظَّالِمُ when a day when the wrongdoer will bite on his hand and will say, يَا لَيْتَنِي I wish that I followed the way of the Prophet, the Messenger. يَا وَيْلَتَى Woe to me! لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانَ الْخَلِيلَ I wish that I didn't take this person as a close friend. He took me away. He made me forget. He made me live in ghafla because he was in ghafla. Well, hadith. يعني everybody knows the hadith. مثل الجليس الصالح والجليس السوء كنافخ أو حامل المسك ونافخ الكير. Always. If you want to choose, يعني sometimes we always pick and try to choose a nice friend for our kids, which is good. But do you ever think of choosing a good friend for yourself? No, you're trusting yourself big time, which is not the case. At the end of the day, لا تصاحب إلا مؤمن. Yeah, don't take a person as a friend except he is a mu'min. Somebody gets you to the masjid, takes you with him to the masjid. وَلَا يَأْكُلْ طَعَامَكْ إِلَّا تَقِيْ These are few of the reasons that gets you, or gets most of us, وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ in that status of ghafla. What should we do? مَاذَا عَلَيَّ أَنْ أَفْعَلْ لما يعني يا شيخ يعني ما تحطنيش في دايلما Don't put me in that puzzle and leave me alone. I need something to get me out of this. First of all, we need to admit. You have to admit that you are in ghafla. If you're listening to my khutbah today and last week, and you're having this struggle in your brain, like, Akhi, I'm not that person, man. I'm okay. Alhamdulillah. I'm not all of this. What are you talking about? Why are you making the image always black in front of my eyes? Then I don't think that what I'm going to say now will help. But if you're not struggling, and if you're not challenging the fact that you and I, in ghafla, let's listen to some of the يعني, things that helps you and I. Very quick, inshallah ta'ala, because of the time. أول شيء that من الأمور التي تساعد الإنسان على الخروج من الغفلة كما يقول علماء هو العلم والعلم بالله تبارك وتعالى هذا أسلوب يعني تعلمنا أن نستخدمه مع الكفار مع الملحدين حتى أن تأتي بملحد إلى الله تبارك وتعالى دعه يعترف أصلا بوجود الله في حياته يعني بقدرة الله حوله أعلمه بهذا الكيان الذي يعيش من خلاله الله تبارك وتعالى أعطاك كذا وكذا وكذا علم نفسك ولذلك الله تبارك وتعالى يقول في سورة فاطر إنما يخشى الله من عباده العلماء والله تبارك وتعالى يقول أيضا في سورة الزمر قل هل يستوي الذين يعلمون والذين لا يعلمون ما أخي ما احنا قلناها يقولي يعني أنت بتجيب واحد the top in line in everything in his field ويجي يدخل المسجد بصيبة وباله بعرفش يصلي يجي واحد يسألك على سؤال يعني 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 تخجل نجيب على الأسئلة لأنه حقه عليه لكن تخجل أن ترد على مسلم عاش مسلما 40 أو 50 سنة وهو لا يحسن الوضوء بعض الناس هكذا ولذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث سيدنا معاوية ابن أبي سفيان رضي الله عنه قال كما جاء في صحيح البخاري ومسلم من يرد الله به خيرا يعلمه الطب من يرد الله به خيرا يعلمه الهندسة من يرد الله به خيرا يعلمه الفيزياء من يرد الله به خيرا يعلمه الرياضيات كل واحد دلوقتي ببص له عشان يتجنن الشيخ الجنة لا يا عم الحديث مش كده اهدى شوية يا شيخ الحديث أنه من يرد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين That's it. Number one of the things that helps you to get out of the ghafla is to know to acquire the knowledge, the needed knowledge for you to practice, to know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the methods that we use with the atheist, with someone who's atheist, you get him and you try to get him admit the fact that there is somebody providing for him, somebody taking care of him, somebody is around him, somebody is there for him, who's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to know that. You have to acquire the needed knowledge to practice your religion. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that clearly in Surah Fatir. إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ. Truly those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from His servants, those who have knowledge. Knowledge. Knowledge about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How come you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Why you don't know Him? You have to know. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, are they equal, those who know and those who don't know? Absolutely not. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and the Prophet said in the authentic hadith, reported by Sayyidina Muawiyah, Ibn Abi Sufyan, I feel happy always when I get a hadith from Sayyidina Muawiyah. Because some people, they give themselves the authority to talk badly about the Sahaba of the Prophet. Who are you? Stay aside here. They are the companions of the Prophet. One of the writers of the Wahy. You have to be very respectful when you talk about them, regardless of what's happening, because we don't know much about what's happening anyway, or what happened at that time. Sayyidina Muawiyah radiallahu anhu reported that the Prophet said, whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wishes good for him, makes him understand his religion. Not medicine, and with due respect, medicine, something great. Engineering, something amazing. Great, we need it. We need physics, we need the math, we need everything. Yani, I wish that my son one day will be a scientist who knows about his religion well. But to be a physician, knows about the body of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates, and what's in there, and you're aware of way more than normal and public people, and you do not pray, shame on you. One word. That's it. And you are in ghafla, shame on you. And you don't appreciate the ni'mah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you, you have to know. Number one, al-ma'rifa billahi tawarak wa ta'ala. Amr al-thani, when I hear, I'm going to be going a little bit more spiritual. Spirituality is very important in our religion. We can't go, stay or work or function in our religion without spirituality always. لذلك قالوا أن الأمر الثاني هو أن يديم الإنسان أبدا أو أن تكون علاقتك دائما متصلة بذكر الله تبارك وتعالى. Tell you something now. Let me ask you a question. How many times you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala per day outside the five times? How many times you sit on your desk at work when you have free time or in your car or at school, at university, and you stick aside and say these 10 minutes only for dhikr, for remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Instead of thinking about me, giving about khutbah, or giving about image, or thinking about him not doing his work, your co-workers, or thinking about wife not making good food, or thinking about everything negative in life, when do you think that you allocate time for remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul fi al-hadith al-sahih, مَثَلُ الَّذِي يَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ وَالَّذِي لَا يَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ كَمَثَلِ الْحَيِّ وَالْمَيِّتِ. The example, the parallel of somebody who remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and somebody who does not remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is exactly like the dead person. Then if I don't remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I'm actually a dead person. It's not only about ghafla here. It's not only about that I'm heedless. I'm actually dead. My heart is dead. It needs lots of work to be awakened, to awaken your heart, to be awake. And the one who remembers Allah like the alive person, and the one who does not remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like the dead person, wal'ayaz billah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is one of the ways that gets you out of the ghafla. هو علاج. وضع علاج النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. وانا هقول لك كده يعني. انت يعني how many times, كم عدد المرات في الاسبوع التي تأتي فيها إلى المسجد غير الجمعة؟ سؤال الإجابة تبقى صعبة جدا. ما بقولكش تصلي أم لا. I'm asking a very simple question now. If you're looking for a solution for the غفلة, let's try to answer this question. يعني how often you go to the masjid per week? Forget about صلاة الجمعة. Not forget about it. Put it aside. How often you go to the masjid? Two times. One time. Not regularly. But alhamdulillah, pray. I know that you pray. But I need to work on your heart. I need you to work on your heart. You need to awaken that fitra. Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول في الحديث الصحيح سيدنا أبو هريرة أيضا في البخاري يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا مررتم برياض الجنة فارتعوا. قال سيدنا أبو هريرة وما رياض الجنة يا رسول الله؟ قال المساجد. قال وكيف نرتع أو وما الرتع يا رسول الله؟ قال سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم in a very amazing hadith. Again, I'm going يعني spiritual. I'm not يعني trying to be tough, but that's the solution. That's the remedy. That's the healing that you need. That's a medication that you and I will need for our heart. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that when you pass by the meadows of the paradise of Jannah, then stay, irta, stay and do something as long as you want. Then the Sahaba, they asked the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, what are the meadows of Jannah? He said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, ما هي رياض الجنة? The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, المساجد, this masjid. That masjid in the south side. That masjid in the north side. The close masjid to your house. We're not saying a specific masjid. Go and sit in the corner, warta. Play, stay, and say this. قال ومن رتع, how we do this, يا رسول الله? He said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, say, سبحان الله, والحمد لله, ولا إله إلا الله, والله أكبر. والله, these things will take this ghafla out of your heart, will awaken the fitra in your heart. Last but not least, always, as we said, يعني, try to understand the reality of this life. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يعني آخر حاجة من الأمور التي يعني تعالج وتساعد على علاج الغفلة هو أن تنظر دائما وأبدا إلى حقيقة هذه الحياة. يعني how long you gonna live for? How long? You have to look at it and you have to understand the reality of this life. ولذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول تذكروا هذه اللذات, تذكروا هذه اللذات ومفرق الجماعات, فإنه ما ذكر في ضيق إلا وما ذكره عبد في ضيق إلا والسعة, وما ذكره عبد في سعة إلا ضيقها. This is the reality, man. Yeah, you need to awaken your heart. Think about your life. تذكر, always remember that you will die sooner or later. Yeah, you will die. That's what Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said in the authentic hadith. Always remember the destroyer. Hatta, he didn't say death. He said the destroyer of all pleasures. The destroyer of this family life that you have. Wallahi al-Azim, one of the hadith that I mentioned before. Amazing, man. It's two nights or statements of the ulama. Your life, all of your life is about two nights. One of them, this night that you are actually enjoying yourself with your family, watching TV, having some nuts, eating some cake, playing some games, looking at your kids going around you, maybe at the same time you're checking your bank account. Think with me, I'm gonna conclude with this. Think with me about this. This is the life that we have. Looking at your bank account, planning for buying something, you made up some money, saved up some money on the side. I need to do this. طبعا, none of this is good to go for Hajj. Some people always complain about the cost. But you do complain about how much is Lamborghini cost or whatever, Jaguar or whatever. Nobody complains about that. But everybody is planning for life. So one of the first night is always enjoying everything around you. وَلَيْلَةٌ أُخْرَى أَنْتَ فِي قَبْرِكَ وَحِيدًا. Then the next night, it might be the next night, wallah, يعني you lived that night that I just described yesterday, you don't know where you're going to be tonight. Don't tell me where, because you don't know. You might be in your grave alone. Alone. Three things follows you. يتبع الميت ثلاثة كلمة من دوتيتك حديث ماله وولده وعمله. Three things follows you to your grave. Your wealth, your children, and your عمل, your deeds. What you've done in this life, يرجع اثنان, two of them, they go back. Your money will go back. The car that you bought, your kids are driving today, they will go back. And your children will go back. ويبقى واحد. Only one thing will stay with you is your عمل, whether it's good or not or bad. So these things will have to awaken the fitra inside us and kick this ghafla away. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always said, يعني تذكروا هادم اللذات, always remember death. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from those who listen and obey. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم وادعو الله تبارك وتعالى وانتم موقنون بالجنة. الحمد لله وكفى وصلاة وسلاما على عباده الذين اصطفى. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. أشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. وبعد. إن شاء الله, as we heard in the announcement before the salah, I always say the easiest cause to collect money for is the masjid. You don't need to advertise. You don't need to, you know, stress or practice any pressure on the brothers and the Muslimin to do ongoing charity for themselves. You're not gonna be more keen on their benefit more than themselves. You're not gonna be, يعني, love them more than they love themselves. At the end of the day, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال في الحديث الصحيح, إذا مات ابن آدم انقطع عمله إلا من ثلاث. When the son, the child of Adam dies, his acts, his deeds come to an end except for three things. Three things can help you in that situation that I just mentioned in the first khutbah, when you are alone in your grave. One of them, and the first one of them, is صدقة جارية, the ongoing charity, the continuous charity that you give only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says also, إنما يعمر مساجد الله من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر. يعني في سورة التوبة, الله سبحانه وتعالى says, يعني those who maintain the messages of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, those who believe in Allah سبحانه وتعالى in the last day. We have our brothers here from Vickerville, small community and small town, and they are, mashallah, starting their masjid. And I know that everybody here wants to have a share with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not in the stock market. No, I'm saying a share with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in building that masjid. Inshallah ta'ala, after the salah, they will be at the doors of the masjid. They're hoping that we are able to help them to push their project, inshallah ta'ala, a masjid for the sake of Allah, the best thing ever you put your money in. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you all the reward of doing that, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for them. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa kaffir 'anna sayyi'atina wa tawaffana ma'al abrar. Rabbana atina fid dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina 'adhaban nar. Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana wa hab lana min ladunka rahma innaka antal wahhab. Allahumma la taj'al lana fi hadha al-yawm al-'azim dhanban illa ghafarta wa la maridan illa shafaita ولا ميتا إلا رحمته ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا لك فيها رضا ولنا فيها صلاح إلى قضيتها ويسر أهلنا رب العالمين ويأخذ دعوان الحمد لله رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين.